In this video, I will show you how to quickly remove a photo background in Adobe Photoshop. Let's check it out. You'll start by opening Photoshop on your computer. If you don't have Photoshop installed yet, or you're unsure if you have the latest version, go to the Adobe website using the link in the video description below to get started. Once you have launched Photoshop, select Open on the left-hand side and select the photo that you want to remove the background from. Once your photo appears on the screen, on the right-hand side, select Layers. You'll see here that your background is currently locked. In order to get started with this process, you'll first need to unlock your background. Then select Properties. On the very bottom of the Properties tab, you'll see Quick Actions. Select Remove Background. One thing about Photoshop is that there are often multiple ways to perform any given task, and this is far from the only method that you can use to remove an image's background. It is, however, the quickest and simplest approach. My background is now removed, and I can make additional edits to my photo before exporting it. To make general photo edits, select the Adjustments tab. Here, you can make edits such as adjusting the color balance, exposure, the brightness, or add presets to your selected photograph. To refine the image further, for example, if I want to smooth out some of the hair on my subjects, I'll need to go up here to the Select tab and click on Select and Mask. One thing I want to call out is if you have the ability to be connected to the internet, make sure that you select Cloud here under the dropdown next to Select Subject for much more detailed results, which could be really helpful when you're doing some of the refined editing that we're going to do next. On the right-hand side here, we have our View Mode, and you can play around with this to see what works best for you and your editing style. You can always start with black and white, which shows you the edge and the outline of your image with the background removed. If you scroll down here to Global Refinements, this is where you can make those edges smoother or feather them depending on what your subject looks like. And this is really going to be just something that you'll have to play around with, and it's going to be based off of each individual image in terms of what settings you're going to want to use. Also here under View, you can click on some of these backgrounds to get a better idea of some of the edits that you're going to need to make to your image. For example, here I see that there's going to need to be some more detailed refinement around some of the hairlines here on the picture. And with this background, it gives me a good opportunity to zoom in here and make those refined edits in greater detail. So now that you've zoomed in, you have a few tools on the left-hand side that you can use to further refine some of these lines here along the hairline. I'm going to select the brush tool, and you can adjust the size of your brush up here as well. Then you'll take your brush and you'll just steadily go along this hairline, and you can see here how that gray is removed, and you're getting a little bit more clean cut right next to the hair. Again, you can zoom in a lot more and use a more refined brush stroke to make this more clear. I'm just really showing you the tools to use today in order to get this done. Once you're happy with how your edits look, you'll go ahead and click on OK. You now have a few options. The first option is to add a new background behind these subjects, whether that's a solid color, a pattern, or inserting another photograph. I'm going to show you how to do that in just a moment. Or you could save this as a transparent image, meaning that anything with this checkerboard pattern will not be viewable once you save this image. To save the image, select File and then Save or Save As. It's important to note that you must save this as a .png file, or else it will not be transparent. Now let's look at adding a new background to your image. Click on Layers. And from here, you can select whether you want a solid color, a gradient, or a pattern to be your new background. If I select solid color, I have a lot of options to choose from. Once you've selected that, you'll notice that your subjects have disappeared. You'll need to reorder the layers and move this down in order for your subjects to appear on top. A fun tool to play around with is the Generate Image tool. And this uses artificial intelligence in order to add images or backgrounds to your photo. There's some options here for you to play around with on the right-hand side, or you can describe the image that you want to generate. In this case, I want to add a house with a yard as my background, and I want it to be a photo. I'll go ahead and select Generate. You'll see that Adobe gives me a few different options that I can select from. Once you've found one that you like, just close up this tab, and you can move your subjects around so that they're better framed in the photo. If you want to resize your objects, use the keyboard shortcut Control plus T, which will then allow you to resize your image. Now, let's say that I actually want to add my own photo here as the background and not an AI-generated image. The easiest way to do that is to open it as a new picture file, and then we'll copy and paste our subjects in. Let's take a look. I'll start by coming up here to File and opening the other photo that I want to use as my new background. This will open it up in a new tab. And then I'll come back here to my transparent background.png and select my subjects. And on my keyboard, select Control plus C for copy. Come back here to my new picture and press Control plus V for paste. Now, you'll notice that this does not look like my subjects, and instead I just have this one really large face, and that's because the sizes between the two images aren't matching, but that's easy to fix. I'll start by clicking on the subjects, and then on my keyboard, use that Control plus T resize again, and from there, I'll go ahead and drag this, grab the corners, and start making it smaller. I'll keep making this smaller to bring my image together. Now we can start seeing the whole image here appear, and we'll go ahead and get this resized exactly where we want. So again, I'm going to make this slightly smaller, bring them in a little bit, and then I can move this on the page where I want it in the photo. And if you're happy with how this looks, you can go ahead and save this image, and you've then taken the previous photo, removed the background, and added a new photo as the foreground. If you want to make additional edits or blur these subjects into the background some more, you can go ahead and do that here under the Adjustments tab. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe so you can watch more videos like this one. And let me know in the comments what other tools you'd like to see highlighted.